What's up, foodie? What's going on with you guys? Thank you so much for all the love you guys give me. Now, for today's recipe, what we're going to be making is we're going to be making some chicken suka kolhapuri style. So without wasting any more of your time, let's get to making the recipe for you. Alright guys, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and marinate the chicken. For marinating the chicken, what we're going to do is we're going to use a little bit of salt, salt to taste. With that, I'm going to go ahead and use a little bit of chili powder. With the chili powder, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and use just a little bit of haldi powder. Our regular marination as always. A little bit of lime juice. And with that, I'm going to go ahead and add a little bit of garlic paste. And then we're going to go ahead and give it a good mix. Alright guys, so we're going to do this recipe one pan style. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take some onions and we're going to go ahead and golden fry them. And with that, we're also going to take some garlic cloves. We're going to take the whole garlic clove and we're also going to fry them as well. Okay, so here is my twist to the recipe. Now when we have our onions and garlic almost done, we're going to go ahead and start adding our dry spices to it. So I'm gonna use ample amount of cumin seeds. With cumin seed, anytime you're making Maharashtrian recipe, there is a lot of dhania that's used in there as well. So we're gonna use ample amount of dhania seed. With that, I have some black pepper, I have some cloves, I have some cinnamon. With that, I'm gonna go ahead and add green cardamom, and with green cardamom I'm gonna add one black cardamom. At the same time, I'm gonna add, so Maharashtrian food is normally very spicy, so I'm also adding some dry chilies to it. And with dry chilies, I'm gonna go ahead and add some poppy seeds with it. We're gonna go ahead and give it a mix, let it cook a little bit. And then I'll come back to you guys. Alright guys, so once our spices have became aromatic, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and turn the heat off. And just in the warm pan, we're going to go ahead and add a lot of dry coconut. Now, Maharashtrian dish, just like any South Indian dish, it's not complete without coconut. We're going to roast the coconut a little bit. And for all my non-Indian friends that doesn't know where Maharashtra is, Maharashtra is on the western side of India, and Mumbai is part of Maharashtra. Let's just make it simple for you. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna let this go out and cool down, cook the coconut a little bit, and once it's cooked, we're gonna go out and make a paste out of it. Alright guys, so once you have your gravy done, what we're gonna do, the last ingredient that we're gonna add to the gravy before and giving it a last mix is we're gonna go ahead and add some nutmeg powder. So once we add the nutmeg powder, we're just going to go ahead and give it one more mix and we should be ready to cook. Guys, so in the same pan, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and add some oil to it. Once we add some oil to it, we're going to go ahead and add some bay leaf. And with bay leaf, I'm going to add some roughly chopped onions. And we're going to go ahead and just saute the onions a little bit. So once our onions are cooked a little bit, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and add our chicken to it. And we're going to cook our chicken until the rawness of the chicken is gone for about 3 to 5 minutes. Alright guys, so once our chicken is halfway cooked, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and add our kolhapuri gravy to it. And with gravy, what we're going to do is we're going to add some water. And also, for the color, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and add about 2 spoon of Kashmiri chili, just to get that redness of the food. And we're gonna let it cook for another 5 minutes or so. Alright guys, so at this point what we're gonna do is we're gonna add salt to taste. And once we add salt to taste, the last thing we're gonna use is we're gonna go ahead and add, I have about 1.5 roughly chopped tomato. Now we're gonna go ahead and add that, give it a good mix. And now at this point, once we go ahead and mix it up, we're gonna let it cook for another 3 to 4 minutes until all the water has evaporated. All right guys, so now at this point, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and sprinkle some fresh cut cilantro, give it a good mix. Now what I usually like to do is As you know, I cook to eat food, and I'm gonna let this simmer until I'm ready to serve the food. That's why you see a little bit more gravy in my chicken. The only reason for that is because, as I said, I'm gonna let this simmer until I'm ready to eat the food. So normally it would be very dry without the gravy. I'll go ahead and upload a picture of it once I'm done and when I'm serving the gravy.
Alright guys, so as you know, the food is ready. I'm not waiting on you. Until next time, I'll see you soon. Thank you.